సాంకేతిక ఉత్సవాలు విద్యార్థులకు పదును పెట్టి స్వీయ అనుభవం గడించడానికి తోడ్పడతాయని సెన్ డిఎల్ఎం సీఈఓ ఎండి రాజేంద్ర వెలగపూడి అన్నారు. గీతం యూనివర్సిటీలో నిర్వహిస్తున్న టెక్నో కల్చరల్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ ఫెస్ట్ ను డీఎస్పీ రాజేశ్వరరావుతో కలిసి ఆయన ప్రారంభించారు. ఈ కార్యక్రమంలో గీతం వైస్ ఛాన్సలర్ ఎన్ శివప్రసాద్, రెసిడెంట్ డైరెక్టర్ డివివిఎస్ఆర్ వర్మ, స్కూల్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ ప్రిన్సిపల్ ప్రొఫెసర్ సంజయ్, స్కూల్ ఆఫ్ వైస్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ రామారావు, గీతం పూర్వ విద్యార్థి లెన్స్ ఫిట్ ఇంటర్నేషనల్ వ్యవస్థాపకుడు వంశీ, చేమకుర్తి తదితరులు పాల్గొన్నారు.
I'm not seeing any energy here. No energy.
Energy.
Yeah. So good morning, everyone. So thank you for giving me an opportunity to be on campus after 4 years. So yeah, I was given just 5 minutes of time. So I'll just give you a brief of what my learnings were in these past 4 years, what I've learned in my BTech, and what I would have done if I'm in BTech now. Right. So my journey. So I'll start as a 15-year-old boy. So how I've taken my career choices. So yeah. And I will see you later. So I think more than 90% of you are from Narayana or Sri Chaitanya, right? So at my age, there was no other choice except medicine. After my family being in engineering wave, right? So my son is an engineer. We call it as MSD or MSE fever. So my son doctor or my son engineer. So my family was away with me with MSE. I joined MTC, and because I was a very bright in academics till 10th class, so I was selected in IPL Madhapur by Sri Chaitanya. It's an IIT Premier League, not an Indian Premier League. So actually my ambition right from my childhood was to become a doctor. And because there are no doctors in my family or my family friends, my parents have suggested me to take up engineering. And many of you would have known how there are 40 to 50 people in a complete Hyderabad, right? So unexpectedly I have to shift my focus from medicine to engineering. And first 3 months of time I couldn't concentrate much, and suddenly a miracle happened. So I topped the examination. It's from the bottom. So, and I kept topping the examination from bottom for the complete month, the third month. Like for us, the exams used to be every week. So there used to be 6-7 exams per week. So after that, slowly I started coping up, and it was more humiliating, right? For to be in the top 10 in my school, and again topping from the bottom in inter. So after that, I coped up with the studies, and I completed my inter, joined in Geetam, and again here the choices, there are many branches. So actually, how many of you know what's the crisp difference between technology and science? At least now, anyone can answer me? What's the difference between technology and science in a single line? Right, so I have no idea of what the difference between technology and science was at that time. And how can someone expect me to choose a career path at that time, right, without an exposure? So yeah, so I just went through the course modules of different engineering subjects, and I found mechanical fascinating, and I joined in mechanical. Right, so there was a lot of intense pressure on me in my plus 11 and plus 12th grade, and I just started enjoying after coming to college, because there was a lot of freedom here. So my 2 years just was there with a blink of an eye. And it is in the third year I have started realizing. So I was just talking to the Manoj, right? If I'm not wrong. So I was just telling Manoj that I was one of the main organizers of Pramana in my batch. So it's from there my actual learning started. So I've organized that and got a chance to interact with many companies. So I was the person who organized more than 10 technical workshops in my Pramana batch. So after that, you know, I sort of told myself that, you know, in inter and while joining SU and while joining DTech, so I don't have any blueprint for what to do in my life, right? So I thought of, you know, I have 2 years of time with me, so let me figure out a blueprint. So how should I be on hot car, you know, what topic should I work on for the rest of my life? So I sort of took time for this, and it's really not easy to, you know, figure out what you want to become. So from deep within. So if you wanted to become engineer, it's fine, well. And if you wanted to become someone else, which is your natural born talent, so you have to find that, and it's really not very easy as it seems to be. So after before fourth year, so I took 1 year, and even I couldn't figure out. I gave my attempts for campus placements. I've written GRE and everything, and then just in the fourth two, I have realized, you know, I have to be doing something which will give an impact in real time. It doesn't necessarily have to be an impact in the long run, but it should be visible to me, you know, in a very short span of time, impacting lives. So that is when I started attending various seminars and various events on startups. And I, on the last row, brought my VTech. Okay, so, yeah. So this is how my journey started, and I've entered into entrepreneurship. So why I've told you all this? So the first thing is that it's totally fine when you are 15 years old or 17 years old, that when you listen to someone else and take up something. But being a 21 year old or 22 year old when you're passing out of a college, so it's completely your responsibility to find out what you want and what you want to become. And I've told you initially that I would also share my, you know, sort of what I want to do when if I was back in BTech right now. So, or to do something new. So, there's a lot of time, right? So, I and my complete friends batch are one-day batches just before exams. So, we used to have this complete semester time free, just freaking out, watching movies and everything. So, yeah. We didn't necessarily use the complete time in a productive way, but if I were in my BTech now, so I would have used that time to explore different things. So there's this saying by one of my mentors. So when you're a 15 year old or 14 year old, you have to learn more and less and less about more and more. So then after figuring out which topic you want to work on for the rest of your life, you learn more and more about the less and less. So you understood what I said? So learn more and more about, first learn less and less about more and more, so that you'll actually understand all the things, what's happening around the world, and then pick up a small segment and learn more and more of that segment. So in today's industry, I don't think so the coursework that you are doing will be actually useful after your BTech, right? More than everyone here must agree with me that more than 80 to 90% of your coursework doesn't necessarily be useful for you after. You know, to make you sort of distinguish between your fellow mates, and what is that extra thing that you have which others don't have, which will make you shine? Or it might be the campus interview, or it might be cracking your dream college in MS, whatever it is. So what is the extra competency that you have? So if you figure out that and start working on that, when you have this much of free time, so it will be really helpful for you. And I was asked on by Trinagrao Garu to talk on what are the opportunities, especially in today's world. So you have various technologies like AR, VR, AI, you know, the computer vision technology, big data, and how many of you hear from mechanical? Mechanical? Very less, because we always spend time in canteens and other places, right? You heard about Industry 4.0? Anyone? No, right? So that is what I'm saying. Apart from your coursework, so you just have to, you know, start, you know, figuring out what are the latest upcoming technologies and how the world is going to change after 5 to 6 years. So I just want to conclude this, because many other dignitaries are waiting on the stage. So I just want to conclude this with a single, you know, quote which kind of pushed me all throughout my 4 year journey. So I was a big fan of Martin Luther King. So he used to say, so if you can't be a bush, so if you can't be a tree, be a bush. If you can't be a sun, be a star. It's not the size that matters, it's what impact you have done in that small area. And if you are not able to run, walk. If not walk, crawl. But don't stop, keep moving. Thank you.
But we face a lot of challenges to face the next gen which is there, the Gen Y and Gen Z in organizations. So before I talk about, just I'd like to give a brief of about my organization, where I'm coming from. I don't know how many of you are aware with a company called Cyient, which was earlier called Infotech Enterprises in the past. So we rebranded and we just coined the company as now Cyient, C-Y-I-E-N-T. It is a publicly listed company. It is close to around, this year we will be touching around $670 million in terms of revenues. And we have close to around 15,000 people who work across the globe. That's what we are today. And what we call it out an engineering services company. So we provide engineering services for all the customers in all the industries, whether it is aerospace, it is semiconductor, or rail transportation, it is consumer medical, it is utilities, geospatial, energy, natural resources. So various industries, we provide engineering designs. To give an example, we work with Boeing, we work with Airbus, we work with Bombardier Transportation, okay, Alstom's, okay, and a lot of big multinational customers where we, and also the aircraft engines. So we are close to around 1500 people who work only on aircraft engine designs. That's what we have a strong strength today in the company. So last 4 years back, we decided to also supplement in the design side what we do into the manufacturing. So we acquired a company who does electronics manufacturing, which is the PCB assemblies and box build, and also a mechanical manufacturing. So now currently we do the customers. That's what the value we are providing, and also it gives us a platform to expand from services to the final solutions to our customers. That's where we are today. And I head the manufacturing portion of a company which is called Cyient DLM, which is a 100% subsidiary of Cyient, which is called DLM, stands for Design-Led Manufacturing. So we do the design and then we manufacture. That's where we are today. And I'm head of the manufacturing division of the Cyient, which is the manufacturing arm. And then once again, just coming back to this event, I'm delighted to see the people here, and also particularly the event which is called as Techno-Cultural Management Fest. Okay. And once he also touched base about what he was probably do, he would do if he is. But probably if you look at it, where we have come from in my engineering studies, probably None of you are born here when I completed my engineering, particularly the students. Okay, so that those were the years we not even known about the computers. Okay, if you go to any computer class, then one or two basic computers should be available at that time, and very very rare opportunity for us to work on the laptops. Probably we never seen it during my engineering days. So those were the days we have come from, and today, you know, the people who are just born, the new guy, after 1 year, they just play with.
Deviated from this routine study, routine curricular activities, and participate in other anti-social activities, which will be definitely landed in hand walls. A simple law states that while driving a motorcycle, one should wear the helmet. It is simple. People, particularly students, they will defy the rules. And lastly, they will be landed in the hospitals, and policeman has to come and sit into the hospital and take the legal action. Why do you give such a chance to others? I advise you not to hack the other's data. But you do it. You know, 4 or 5 years of jail term for them. Hacking, copying, others important information or rights without the knowledge of the author. If you do it now, definitely you will be hooked and you will be sent for the jails. You will be rusticated from your institutions if it is proved. So there are simple IT Act 2004, very stringent laws are there, and you should not indulge any such morphing or copying or hacking. There are other things like which I do not want to elaborate. A little bit. Social and ethical education, you know, and moral education is very much important, though. You learned a lot about the scientific and this technological education. Without the moral education, without the cultural education, without the moral responsibility, you cannot do it. So such events are very much required to infuse these cultural activities among the students. So Gita University is a wonderful university, and taking up such programs is appreciated, and Varma sir also very well known to me. He said they are for constitution. I wondered why constitutions are required when such a congenial atmosphere will prevail in the industry, when such good students are there, still he is afraid of the law and problem. So I said, okay, our constitution will be there, but they will not be given any task list. So required a lot of people will come, and otherwise it will be disturbing this peaceful atmosphere. So everywhere, wherever you go, police is required. Police is required. If you are know something about laws, if you know something about social and moral ethical responsibility, you don't require any police like this. Because our strength is very meager, very meager for your kind information. Our 2,000 people per one concept is lucky. Metropolis is like Hyderabad. You think about the rural area. So DG, Sri Mahendra Reddy, got with a good idea that technology means new development, not policemen developing technology. Technology development, students like you, is being much used in the police department, and our department is using technology. Through technology, we are controlling crime, and through technology, our force is being multiplied. One concept is doing by using technology. Equal to 100 constables. One constable is discharging duties of equal to 100 constables by using only simple technologies which were developed by none other than students like you, please. I am appreciating the engineering students, and they are developing, they are giving a lot of useful things to the social society and for the nation development. And our police department motto is that we will have a friendly police. We will have a friendly police. We'll even a criminal comes also, we'll treat him as a friend, but law will not treat him as a friend. We'll treat him as a friend, and legally whatever action you have to take, we'll take. So people started realizing our work and appreciating that police are friendly nowadays, and in future also, we'll do a lot of things. And lastly, I would like to thank you, Gita University, and I would like to thank you all the people for giving me this opportunity. And thank you, one and all, particularly the Vice Chancellor, Mr. Shivakala, inspired him after seeing him. And such professors are required to modify our students in future as well. I am very much thankful to you, sir. Thank you very much.